In this video, I'll describe what experiments and observational studies are and how we can use them to answer research questions. Over the years, you might have seen various news stories about the health benefits of drinking coffee. Let's think about two potential research questions we could ask. First, do people who drink coffee live longer than people who don't? And the second is, does drinking coffee cause you to live longer? Pause the video and think about whether these two questions are really asking the same thing, and how we'd go about answering each one. Although these questions sound similar, they're actually asking two very different things, and we would use different methods to answer them. Let's think about the first question. What we'd do to answer this is to get a lot of people to participate in the study, and then we'd find out which people regularly drink coffee and which people don't. Then we'd follow all of the participants for the rest of their lives and record their ages when they died, and take the average for each group. Let's say that the people who drank coffee, on average, lived 76.2 years, and the non-coffee drinkers lived an average of 74.7 years. So the answer to our research question would be, yes, people who drink coffee tend to live longer than people who don't drink coffee. Now, does this also answer the second research question? Does drinking coffee cause you to live longer? At first, it might seem like we've answered that question. But what if females were more likely than males to drink coffee? Maybe it was the participant's sex that was causing the longer life. Or maybe people who are more active are also more likely to drink coffee, and it was their exercise that caused the longer life. Since the participants chose whether or not to drink coffee, we can't rule out these alternative explanations for the longer lifespan for the coffee drinkers. But there is an alternative method we could use to answer the second research question. In order to investigate cause and effect, we need to use random assignment. First, we'd recruit a bunch of volunteers. Then, we'd randomly assign them to one of two conditions. The first group would be forced to drink 2 cups of coffee every day for the rest of their lives. The second group would be prevented from drinking any coffee for the rest of their lives. And then we'd measure their age when they died. And let's say the coffee drinkers lived an average of 76.2 years, and the non-drinkers lived an average of 74.7 years. So again, the coffee drinkers lived longer. Can we conclude it really was the coffee that was the cause? Could it be that being female was the cause? Well, since people were randomly assigned to the two groups, each group should have the same number of females. Could it be that exercising regularly was the cause? Again, since people were randomly assigned to the two groups, each group should have the same number of exercisers. Although it's possible that drinking coffee makes people exercise more, which then increases lifespan. But that's an issue for another video. So with this research design, we can probably conclude that it was drinking the coffee that caused the difference in lifespan. Now, let's think about the two research questions that we've looked at. The second research question was, does drinking coffee cause you to live longer? To answer this question, we used a technique called an experiment. An experiment is a technique in which researchers subject participants to an intervention. In our example, it was drinking coffee or avoiding coffee. The different levels of the intervention are called the treatment or explanatory variable. Then, the researchers measure values of a response variable. In our experiment, it was the age of the participants when they died. Experiments typically involve randomly assigning participants to levels of the treatment variable. Doing this usually allows us to make a cause and effect conclusion. Now, you might be thinking, if experiments let us draw cause and effect conclusions, why don't we always use them? Well, there are some potential issues with experiments. First, some experiments are unethical. It's probably not okay to force some people to drink coffee and to prevent others from doing so. Generally, you need to do experiments in a laboratory setting, but it might be impractical to do this. And similarly, it might be expensive. So when these issues arise, researchers turn to observational studies. We used an observational study to answer the first research question, which was, do people who drink coffee live longer than people who don't? In observational studies, when we collect data by observing the behavior without controlling the levels of a treatment variable. In our example, some of our participants chose to be coffee drinkers, and others chose to not drink coffee. And then we observed and compared how long the two groups of people lived. By doing this, we avoided ethical issues and the need to collect data in a lab. But a significant issue was that we couldn't draw cause and effect conclusions. So now we've looked at an example of an experiment and an observational study. They allow us to address similar research questions, but they have different strengths and potential issues.